Love is forgiving. Love is obedient. Love is honest. Love is caring. Love is understanding. Love honors. That is what love is all about. The day you realize that marriage is not about sex is the day you start relieving the real purpose for marriage. That's the day you understand that all of us have got to do something to bring food on our dinner table. That is the day that a young, brilliant African man or woman from Uganda or Liberia or Ghana realizes that marrying the bone of your bone is the one that is important. That is the day that we are going to take relationship and marriage as a lifetime event, a lifetime investment that is not worth playing about. That is the day that we will start moving in the right direction to have the right thinking, because we've got to have the right mind. To marry the bone of your bone, the person with the vision, the person with admirations, the people who can hold you, the people who can support you, the people who can be enablers to your dreams and admirations, the people who will cry and laugh with you when you're down on your luck, and they are alive and well in supporting you to make sure that you rise up. A lot has been given to you by your parents, you know. But then, to whom much has been given, a lot is expected. A lot has been given to you by your parents, friends, and relatives. So it is upon you now to do that which is good and that which will shape the direction that you think for in the future. That you will no longer think about properties and birthday parties of about 3 million as the event that is trending. That we will think not about the white or green or blue party, but then we are alive and well in working our relationship and making sure that we marry people who are our bond, the real people who are sharing our dreams and admirations. They may not look like it, they may not sound like it, because I tell you for free, if it sounds like a duck, it looks like a duck, then surely it can never be a pigeon. And so let us work for that, so that we achieve what we want. The day we realize that it's not about trending and moving in the, you know, in people's cars and moving and trending on social media or in whatever it is that you can talk about, the day we realize the real purpose for which God created us. Let's seek to find people who are going to be supporters than enablers to our dreams. They may not seem like it. They may not look like it, because the Yoruba people have a saying that 20 children do not play together for 20 years. So that time for them to emerge, to be the best of the people they can, is going to come. And then we have got to do it together to support one another, to see that we have received the unlocked potential in them. The locked potential should be unlocked by all of us doing something to make sure that we get there, you know. So let's not be able to point blames here and there, but let's be willing to do things to help us and shape the African continent we all deserve, to make sure that we do and move through this politically turbulent time, for example, in Uganda, to make sure that we, the youth, stand together and do things to help ourselves, not only in our marriages, but as well for our country. Uganda, so rich, and nobody can ever call us a shitful nation. Nobody has the audacity to question our values, because we know better. And we can do that which anybody could do. Nobody can tell us they are the only one with the vision, because they are not immortal. They will die one day, but all of us who have the dreams and admiration for a better nation will rise up and do things willingly and betterly in an organized manner to make sure that we rise up in the right direction, that we will no longer think about Lincoln, Abraham to define our democracy, but we have the young, brilliant men and women of Uganda from across the African continent, from across the world, in different civilizations, coming back to Africa, coming back to Uganda to build and shape the Uganda we all deserve.